Well, the hubs are done and the masks are off, and footy's back in Melbourne with crowds, if you don't mind. And with Furphy on board, Teams on 10 is bigger, better and weirder than ever. Let's go! Woo! Yes, indeed it is. Teams on 10. Nick Butler alongside the former Blue and Giant, and now he's just a rock star of podcasting and social media. The number one man, Dylan Buckley. G'day, Dilly. Great to be back. Yes, you can do it now. Yes.
Yeah. Great to be back, Nick. It's absolutely fantastic to be back. I don't know how we got approved for another season.
No, it took a little bit to do, but wonderful news with Furphy on board. Furphy Refreshing Ale is unbelievable, and the boys are very happy about getting a few cartons. So we are back for the whole year and very excited. Do you need a DP?
No, still don't need it. No, no, I'm fine. Thank you, though.
Hey, big, big show. We've got guests in the studio. Who have we got? A couple of my faves.
Massive show. Season 2, 2021. We've got a big, big show from the Richmond Football Club, Liam Baker, one of my favourite players.
Snake.
We're getting him in soon. Also in the studio, first guest in the studio.
Yep.
Big Josh Battle from the St Kilda Footy Club, so very exciting.
Batsy is real old school footballer, flash car. I've got a bit of dirt on Batsy, so he's got a big job too with the Saints with a few injuries.
He does, very, very important.
Yeah, so great to have him in.
Actually, Nick, congratulations to you as well, my friend, becoming a father, yes. Young Ted. What's it been like?
It's good, mate. I'm sort of going off the old 45 minutes of sleep, but...
You look tired.
Thank you. He's a beautiful boy, long-limbed. I reckon he'll sort of take a few grabs.
A bit more coordinated than the old... Hopefully gets the mother's genes.
Yeah, I used to wave in the planes a bit. But let's hope so. He's going, well, cries and poos and all that sort of stuff. But love him.
Congratulations.
Thank you, mate. Hey, straight into it.
Yes.
Juices flowing. What has got or is getting your juices flowing just on the eve of the season?
Yes, well, obviously 24 hours out from round one, and one of the biggest things for me that I get so excited about, and call me strange, but it's number changes.
Yes, yeah.
Player jumper number changes. It's seeing what draft picks come out with a new number on their back at a team, and I go, ooh, who's that?
Caller's
not. It's also maybe a player traded to another team. For example, someone that I cannot wait to see run out, and he won't be doing it this week, but Zach Williams, number 6 from 29. It rattles me. The difference of the number, I like to sort of pick up on those sort of things.
Yeah, so I can't get my head around him in the 6.
It's weird.
Any more examples?
That's the only one I thought of, to be honest, early, but I was hoping
you'd
have some.
It would be a long sleeve 6.
You'd have some as well. It would be. Well, Simo's obviously there from Cade Simpson, made that number so famous, but Zach coming in will be big, and even seeing what number Jesse Hogan's going to get, what number all these players are going to get from different trades.
Well, Jezza Clayton's got my juices flowing a little bit because he's taken the 5, the God. And as I said to you, I think in the grand final show, I held up the 52 and I DM'd Jez and said, mate, I'd be wrapped if you took it on. The 14 games at Geelong, the 52 that I wore with pride and honour and dignity. And he said, Butts, I'll do you a bit of a deal, mate.
I'll take one of them.
I'll take the 5. Yeah, so now I'm up and about that. Can I have my juice?
Please do. What is it?
Okay, a couple. I've got a couple because I'm a new father
said,
and
you
I'm
said
all,
one.
All up and about. No, I've got 2. So I took the family for our first little road trip a couple of weeks ago. We went down to the coast and I had one of those fancy Apple TVs, right, where you can get 10
fancy
play.
Dad.
And I was sitting back with a Furphy thinking I've got the young son and we've got a show coming and life's pretty good. And I put it on the grand final show and I didn't realise how good we were. Or how good I was. So if we roll a bit of the stuff here, like me and Mikey Brady were just on fire.
That was me hiding.
So that, I tell you what, I was that juicy, I almost slipped off my chair. I was just covered in juice. And look at me there! Yes, so that's what we're all about.
Can you see this? I actually still have nightmares about that show.
Why?
Well, you were trying to get me up to sing and I just didn't want... I was melting into the couch behind Mike Brady.
See, management weren't overly... I had to do some smoothing over with that. They said, he's still a real... You're a performer, Nick. You're old school. You grab a mic, you get up with Mike Brady. They go, Dylan's got this social media following and he's cool and he dresses like Tony Hawk and all that. But is he a performer? And I had to write emails. I had to speak to your manager. You're going to get some singing lessons.
Yeah.
And as these sponsors come on, there will be a performance aspect to your contract.
Yeah.
And just like a footballer that needs to run
perform
both ways or play.
Yeah, yeah,
so you need to sing. Anyway, The other one that just got me going was watching a little bit of the pre-season footy just to get in the zone. And I love the new rule. I love the man on the mark can't move. Well, I never moved much manning the mark anyway, but it's brought the tall forwards back in. So if you're 6 foot six and you've got a bit of a spunk and ability like Jezza, you can just do that because the ball's getting in quick. And I think every fan, every coach and every big player is keen on this sort of stuff.
Nick.
The big man is back in
vogue.
If you're big and you've got hands, look at that big Butler in the wet. I think maybe if it's stirred on the Adelaide Oval. Butler!
That rule has so many benefits in the game. Mm. That is not one of them, okay? that happens anyway from the big boys. That has nothing to do with manning the mark. Now, I'm putting in a rule this year. Mm. Every highlight that comes up, not even every time, every highlight, it's $50 to a charity.
My highlights?
Yes. Oh, not even highlights, your lights that come up on the screen.
Look, I think that's fair. My father actually did say to me, you're a father now. You're a very ordinary
Ted's
footballer.
Ted's going to have to grow up and watch
Stop
this one day.
Stop showing your highlights. You're embarrassing me as your father and the rest of the family. And I said, Dad, I find it funny and I think Dill likes it.
No.
I don't think he does.
No.
So I will. Every time I show a highlight from this point, I will donate $50 to Pucker Up.
Yes.
Schwatter there. I think I can budget for about $400.
We'll reassess at round four.
And that goes for you too. If we roll your horrendous...
We don't have enough time to put my highlights up. We don't have enough time.
Or anything, you headbutted a bloke when you played
GWS. That was an
any of that, you're $50 in as well. What's your charity?
My charity is... Tackle Your Feelings. Tackle Your Feelings. Great initiative at the AFL Players Association. They go out and educate coaches on how to deal with players in mental health. So I like that one.
50 a highlight. I like it. Tackle Your Feelings and Pucker Up.
Just on this, sorry, Nick, can I jump in?
You really?
Because I'm co-hosting now. I'm not sitting behind the players anymore. On that new rule, it's going to be so exciting to actually see how that comes in tomorrow night.
Yep.
First up, through the guts, the ball's just going to be pinging. It's going to be so quick. We've seen every nearly game hit 100 points.
Yeah. I do like it. Very quickly, I've got two for you. I'm getting a wind up. We're a bit rusty because we haven't had a practice game.
Yeah. My bad.
Carlton Richmond memories. You played in a couple? Were you a cat on a hot tin roof? Could you sleep? Could you hold down your brekkie? These are big games, and we've got 50,000 there tomorrow. Liam Baker on the line. We'll go to him shortly. What do you remember about them?
Not good memories, unfortunately. I played one round, one game, three touches in the game.
Yeah, that's
in front of about 90,000 people.
Good
so I think
pressure.
the nervousness and anxiety got to me a little bit. In all seriousness, it is a big, big game. You're training for so long for this game. Every single person that watches footy is watching it. So it's very nerve-wracking.
Can't wait. And before we go to a break and get to Bates, there is some news in footy. Now, the sub vest is back. And not a concussion sub, which I find a bit weird. It's a general injury sub. And we have exclusively the Icon sub vest that potentially some players will be wearing this week. You would have made a great sub. Quickly, what are your thoughts on it? I think it's a bit weird. I was happy to wear the concussion. If you get a head knock now after listening to your Paddy McCartan on your podcast, we have to get serious. If a bloke is dazed and confused, he comes off, a guy in the vest comes on, you can do a calf and get subbed out. I don't like it.
Yes, it's look, without knowing the full legislation of what the rule is, I don't want to get too committed to it, but if it's fully injuries, it is a bit strange. It's just like bringing a sub back.
You can pick a groin and you're off. Fake one.
If that's what it is, that's quite strange. I think I'm all for the concussion because I know how serious it is. And obviously all the research going into concussion, CTE now is massive. So we've got to look after our heads.
Lots to talk about. Liam Baker from the Tigers is at Punt Road, ready to go. We'll be back with him after this short break. Teams on 10 is proudly brought to you by Furphy Refreshing Ale. Unbelievable. Yes, welcome back to Teams on 10, brought to you by Furphy Refreshing Ale. Well, it all gets underway tomorrow night. The Tigers up against the Blues, and this man, Liam Baker, will be right in amongst it. Liam, thank you so much for joining us on Teams on 10. You must just be pumped to get out there in front of 50,000.
It's been a while at the G with a big crowd as well, hopefully. So we're very excited about that, me especially. I've never played a round one game. Well, I played last year, but there was no crowd, so... availing of the two flags as well. So, yeah, we're all pretty excited down at Tigerland.
Liam, it's Dill here, mate. Congratulations. You're a two-time premiership player. A few of your teammates are three-timers. How do you keep the hunger? How do you go again? Are you ready for a fourth or a third?
Yeah, absolutely. Last year, it was, I enjoyed it a lot more than the year before. And I I want to have another crack at that success this year. And there's going to be boys that missed out last year that are going to be pushing the blokes that played. So the hunger's there from everyone, each individually and as a collective, because we want to win another flag, and it starts on Thursday night.
Bakes, just on your own career, I remember a couple of years ago, you were a rough-headed rookie in the high number and the mullet, and you were driving around in a bomb and you were glaring at the media. And then fast forward a couple of years, you're a two-time premiership player and a top 10 in the BNF and a star. Do you pinch yourself at how your career is going?
Yeah, absolutely. I had the same thoughts in my first year. You know, this is just going to be a yearly thing before I get the boot. Things panned out pretty well, but I've still got plenty of time in my career, hopefully, and more areas to improve. But, yeah, I've come a long way from driving the old beaten-up car and, you know, looking a little nice and rough that I was a few years ago. Not that I'm looking much better now.
No, I very much like you. Look, what are you steering these days, Bakes? Are you rocking it with the big boys in the car park?
I've upgraded, yeah. I got myself a nice Land Cruiser, so keep it rough and tough.
Liam, what do you get up to away from footy, mate? I know how full-on it can be. Have you got any passions outside the game?
Yeah, away from footy, I play a fair bit of golf with Brody and Fridge Graham mostly, and Shorty a bit when we can get him out there. But I love going away camping, just hanging out with the boys, that kind of stuff. Like I said, with my car, I like to get away and, you know, just pretty much relax and kick back and try and take your mind off footy a bit, and getting out there in the bush is the best way to do that.
I brought this up earlier in the show, and something I'm very passionate about is number changes. Now, yourself, you're a rookie. You've gone from the 48... now going to the prime time on Hollywood Boulevard there, number 7. Talk me through that change, mate. Was it a hard choice to make? Because I know how sentimental you can get with numbers.
Yeah, I didn't mind 48. Lambo and Grimey used to wear that, so that's why I was pretty happy when I first got it. But my jumper was so small and the number was so big. It was wrapping around the sides of my jumper, so I had to get rid of it and go a bit smaller and, you know, get a nice locker. But, I like the way we, you know, do your time in the high number and then earn the rights to get a smaller one.
Hey, Liam, I'm a bit of an old dinosaur and I'm a bit obsessed with old-fashioned coaches' sprays. And having a bit of a look at the Amazon doco, which is fantastic, gee, Dimmer gave you guys a bake against Frio late in the year. What are your recollections and you know, did that knock you around a bit?
Yeah, a few of my previous coaches gave pretty good bakes, so that's my first big one from Dimmer. But I thought it was, I don't think the camera did it justice. I thought it was a lot bigger that when we were there live than the Amazon doco showed. But yeah, we probably deserved it that night and got the result in the end. So who cares, really? We're all grown up enough to handle it.
Bakes, the Blues haven't won a game in round one since 2012. Being honest here, mate, do you think they're a chance of even really pressing you guys on Thursday night?
Yeah, they're a very good side. They've obviously got a few new recruits in from that team that went pretty close to knocking us off last year. And the way they played in that pre-season game against the Saints, yeah, it was very exciting. They were very fast, so we need to be weary of that. It's going to be a quick game, I think. We just need to you know, do what we do best and play the game as it comes in front of us, whether it be quick or slow. But, yeah, we should be right, and, yeah, it should be a good game, I think.
Now, Bakes, with Furphy on board every week with our special guests, we're going to do a fact or Furphy. And this one's close to my heart because just before Christmas in my role at 10 News, I came down and got some vision of Dusty Martin just burning up the track in a 6-minute time trial. And I reported that he won and I got absolutely smashed and called a liar and a fake news journalist and all this rude stuff on social media. Fact or Furphy, did Dusty win the time trial?
I think that's Furphy.
No!
they do it, they spread it out, so you all start from different spots and you try and end at the same point, you know, and everyone's got different targets, and Dusty happened to be the one at the front, but he has been flying, but I don't think he was winning the time trial.
I think that's half fact and I'm sticking with it. Hey, Bakes, good luck tomorrow night. We love the way you play and make sure you start the season well. Just quickly as well, you get the best prize pack in footy for giving us a bit of your time. Have a look at this if you don't mind. The Teams on 10 prize pack, a one-year unlimited wash club membership at participating locations thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash. Magic Wash Club is cleaner, safer, faster. You'll love that. A power drill thanks to Icon Construction, a new Icon, a $50 breakfast voucher at Cheeky Monkey Cafe on Swan Street, a one-on-one Pilates session at Motion Health Toorak, a slab of Furphy Refreshing Ale. You can knock those off when you beat the Blues. And from the neighbour cellar, you get a nice bottle of Shiraz. How good's that, Bakes?
How good. Thanks for having me, boys. It'll all come in handy, I'm sure.
There you go. What a star he is. I reckon
impressive
he likes a power drill.
Impressive prize pack.
Good prize pack.
Wow.
Oh, the boys are like, we're having to knock a few back, sort of stand in line. It's a bit like getting a ticket to the footy. So we'll get you all on Teams on 10. We don't actually give you the teams, but we get around the teams and we celebrate what's fun and funny in footy. Oh, Liam Baker doesn't
have
a lot of media. He should do more.
We get the exclusives.
Now, talking of big news, yes. and I think sort of Bakes has kind of confirmed that my Dusty Martin report was right.
No, I didn't think he did that at all, actually.
There'll be no
retraction. Yeah.
The iconic moment was big last year where we got to delve back and look at all these special moments. We had Simon Madden and we had Kuda and we had Tony Shaw knuckling on and all this great stuff. Well, the good news, it's back. Let's have a look at some of the highlights from last year.
Snow game was an interesting game because it was the first time ever in AFL history that a game had been played in the snow.
We've officially got snow down here.
Oh, Daisy, wow.
So they were a very, very good side through a good era and we beat them twice. So, we were pretty good.
Yes, the Icons are back in 2021 and we're very excited about that. But the bigger news...
Big news!
Steph Clarkson is on board and will be bringing us the iconic moments every week. Steph, great to have you.
Very exciting to be back. I'm very glad to be back.
New team member, Nick.
Yes.
Very exciting.
It's good.
We're growing.
We are growing.
It's a community.
Growing. And we're pivoting and developing and all those buzzwords. Hey, a lot of these players were knocking around on the field before you were born. How are you going to go about the research?
Yeah, to be honest, a couple of people we had last year I had to do a quick Google before, but got Dad to tell me a couple of stories as well. He's got a few from behind in the olden days. We're going, way back to like, what, the 1800s?
Yeah.
Was footy even around
then? Yeah, Nick was born then.
I know, yeah.
Your dad would love it though.
Like, yeah.
He's a footy nut and you love your footy. So, you know, it's great. We're putting a millennial spin on these great old and hot, you know, highlights of the game.
Yeah, it's really good. And to get the two perspectives as well, to have someone that has so much knowledge on the game and so much old knowledge of the game as well as the modern. Mm. And then to have a girl that's coming up and like through footy sort of reporting, it's really good to get that parallel and sort of see like what the different inputs and like understandings are of everything. So, it's been good.
We're excited, Nick.
We're pumped. Now, old man Alistair made a few headlines with this man over the summer break when Alistair came on the podcast.
Indeed.
And all hell broke loose when he mentioned the four Ps. Let's have a look.
Within our club, and this will now become outside of our club, we talk about the four Ps, which is the piss, the punt, the penis and the powder.
Yep.
There we go, piss, punt, penis, powder. That was amazing. And I'm a young father now, and I think little Ted is going to hear about the four Ps too. Did he drill that into you in the Clarkson house?
Oh, 100%. Before I was, like, ended puberty and get onto the stage of, like, becoming a woman, as people would stereotypically say,
yes.
Dad sat us all down at the kitchen table, my siblings, and was like, all right, time for you guys to learn about the four Ps. We're like, what are the four Ps? My boyfriend that I've just recently started dating a year ago, he sat him down at the dinner table and goes, all right, Jackson, four Ps. And Jackson was like, Steph, what is this? This is so embarrassing. And he felt so awkward. And Dad was sitting there like, seriously, obviously taking piss and joking about it, but sitting there being like, you got to live up to these four Ps. They get you through life.
I'm
so embarrassing.
Nervous thinking about that. Sitting down.
I
was sitting down with Al straight in front of him, and I was nervous. I was so nervous. I cannot imagine how your poor young boyfriend went. But no, I've got to thank Clarko for that one. Geez, we hit some headlines.
It was so good.
He's really helped old mate Dill out there on the pod.
Well, we're very excited to have you on board. Steph, quickly, can you give us a teaser? Yeah. First icon, iconic moment next week. Give me an old legend that you're going to track down.
Well, we're going to try and get Damien Monkhurst from his Collingwood day, see how that goes, get some good stories for him and how he's progressed in his life to now. He's actually
Ruck
doing
coach?
Some farmer. Ruck coach at Hawthorn. Yeah. Yeah, so that should be really good. And we'll see if we can get Pikey and a couple of other old guns as well.
Yeah, tough.
And teams on 10. Teams on 10 socials at Teams on 10. Let us know. Sorry, at 10 Sport. Let us know who you want on, and Steph will go out and ask the hard-hitting questions. So it'll be very exciting.
Request an iconic moment.
Yep.
Yeah, just chuck it in the DMs.
Yeah, I like it. Real millennial language. Hey, very, very exciting. Time for a quick break. Joshy Battle, the stud from St Kilda, next. Teams on 10 is proudly brought to you by Furphy Refreshing Ale. Unbelievable. Yes, welcome back to Teams on 10. Well, the Saints head up to GWS to take on the Giants, and they've got a few out, and this man has a very big role. Josh Battle, great to have you in the studio. We love it. In the studio.
We do. No. We're excited.
Josh, you must be pumped. It's a hard task for you first up, though.
Yeah. No, firstly, thanks for having me, and, it's good to be back. I think it will be pretty tough going over there, so, yeah, we're looking forward to it.
Tell you what, not everything's... Sorry, Dil. Just quickly... Have you ever run over a black cat in the car park or something? You've got 8 out. I mean, everything's going on. Golf balls, players needing a bit of personal leave, injuries. It's not panic stations, though.
Nah, I think, obviously, that's something that we try and pride ourselves on at the moment. We had a fair few injuries last year, so... I think we're pretty unlucky at the moment to have all these injuries, but, I think the guys that will come in will, replace them really well.
Joshy, it's an honour to have you in the studio, mate. There's a reason I'm actually sitting in between the talent and Nick. He gets a little bit of weird around players. We've had requests from St Kilda especially. He got a bit weird with Rowan Marshall last year, which we don't want to bring up. But, mate, massive fan of yourself. I love the swinging type. You go from forward when they need you, you go back. What have you been training this year? Where can we see you lining up?
So this year I've been training more forward and then probably wing. It started when Rats came in a couple of years ago. I started as a forward, then he came across from Hawthorn and sort of put me down back. And, now I think he's more on, I'll just try and stick you in one position instead of sometimes I'll go into games, start in here and then end up at the other end. But, I think it's been good for my development. So,
100%.
More forward.
It's been a great development, I suppose, and I know what you're saying, you want to stick to one. One thing I love about the Saints, what they're doing at the moment, is they're really big in this mindfulness space. We see the boys doing some breathing techniques throughout the breaks. Talk us through that. How does it come about and do you get a benefit out of it?
Absolutely. So it's been good. Ben Robbins, who's come in, he's like our psych. So, he's come in and really brought this mindfulness into the game. And I think it's been really important. At the start, we were a little bit unsure of it. But, now that we've been doing it, we all love it. And we all have different triggers. And it just it helps us stay in the present. And, I think when we make mistakes, you can get rid of them easier and stuff like that. So, it's been really good.
That'll be good for us on the show.
Yeah.
Because we make a few. You just got to get back in. Hey, Josh, the Winx King thing has blown my mind. You'd cop a hamstring or an ankle or an AC joint or something, but a golf ball to the scone with his mates the week before round one. Tell me about your reaction when you found out and how is the young fella?
I know. He's pretty unlucky. He's actually playing with one of our ex-teammates, his best mate, Jack Bell.
Oh, yeah.
No. So
he's dirty on him, I've heard.
Yeah, I think he's pretty fat. No. But we found out on the Monday morning. We found out on the Friday, so it happened on the Thursday on our day off, and then Rats got us all together and told us that Friday morning that he won't be able to play next week because he got hit in the head by a golf ball, and we all sort of had a bit of a laugh. But yeah, he was serious. So. we're pretty flat for him. I know he was definitely he was definitely flat, but. He'll be back next week. So, hopefully, he goes well.
And for all those Mad Saners, and your supporters are fantastic and mad, can we get a bit of an injury update? Big Ro Marshall, who I do love him a bit creepy with Ro. Paddy Ryder, have you spoken to him? You've got a couple of other major injuries as well, but start with those two big boys. How long?
I think Ro's going really well. He's running and everything. He's had a bit of a foot problem. So, I think he'll be back pretty early. Paddy's just gone back home to spend some time with his family. And, I think hopefully he's back pretty soon. There's a few others. Gears broke his leg. I think he's going really well. Hannah's has tracking along really well. So, yeah, I think everyone in rehab's moving pretty good, so I think they'll be all back pretty soon.
Yeah, and we do send our love to Paddy Ryder, one of our favourites here at Teams on 10, absolute superstar. You spoke about the leadership stuff coming with the Saints now. Jack Steele's walked in. Is it co-captaincy there now? Has there been a bit of a shift in change, or is it, you know, business as usual?
Yeah, pretty much business as usual. I mean, he was a really good leader for us. He's been a good leader for us the last few years, but I think now he's been, I guess he's still the same leader, but he's just been identified as one of the main leaders now. But yeah, he hasn't changed at all. I mean, well, that's why we all voted for him, because we love how he goes about it, and just his connection with everyone throughout the club's really good. So yeah, he'll be a great leader.
One more kind of serious one before I've got some funnies. I've done some digging. Hey, injury sub. It's just dropped. It's not only concussion. You can do a calf and be subbed out. As a player, what's your initial reaction?
Yeah, so I just found out about it literally 20 minutes ago. So yeah, I think it'll be good. I think it'll be good for the game. Obviously, it would have been good last year with the short turnarounds and stuff like that to, I guess, rest a few players and manage their loads. But, yeah, I think it's good if someone goes down early, like we saw in the granny last year, then someone can come on and replace them.
OK, now, very good answer. We love a bit of off-Broadway digging sort of stuff. And for you, I just remember, you are a real... You had a presence from when you rolled in.
He still does. Look
at him. He's got the tats. We like the ink work. I want to ask you about that in a minute. But firstly, the green machine. When you were drafted as a young fella at Halebury, and there's a little bit of a story getting round when they did the profile and you rocking round in the brand-new green Commodore, I think we can roll. And have a look at this for some sort of rock star. Talk to me about the green machine days when you're an AFL player at school.
So that was actually the first car like I got it off my uncle, and then the AFL come out to do a segment on me being at school, and then yeah, they just saw my car and turned it all into the green machine. So
how quickly have you learnt to not let media just decide things?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. I know, and I'm still copping so much.
If you had seen my first episode on this show, this bloke made me wear a full Carlton kit. Oh. I've buried it.
I'm still copping crap from that now. It's coming up in team meetings and everything. So
did you sell the green machine? What happened to the green machine?
Yeah, burn it the next day. Got rid of it.
Josh, you've been fantastic. Final one, because we've got Furphy Refreshing Ale on board, we must have the fact or Furphy. Now, I don't know if this is right, but you do have some beautiful fangs. Is that has there been a bit of a dentist chair job there, or are they just naturally very white?
No, so I did have braces when I was a kid, and then got them off and they touched them up. But yeah, I'm running with a nickname at the club at the moment, Chompers. So everyone's Rats has picked up. Like, I've been called for it from Aaron Hamill, one of the coaches, for the last 2 years, but Rats has just heard it the other week, and now
he loves it.
He's just running riot with it. So.
They're beautiful chompers. I wouldn't be afraid of that nickname. It's better than brown fangs or something, so go with it. Hey, Joshy, you've been a star. Yes. Good luck on Sunday, and those Saints supporters need you to play well. You've got probably a bigger responsibility now, so we're sure you will. You look mighty fit. And for taking the time to come in, you get the great prize pack. It is the best prize pack in footy, and I'll read it now. The one-year unlimited Wash Club membership at participating locations, thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash. Magic Wash Club is cleaner, safer, faster, so you can roll the Merc through there. A power drill thanks to Icon Construction. They're the new Icon. A $50 breakfast voucher at Cheeky Monkey Cafe on Swan Street. A 101 Pilates. You like the Pilates? Down at Motion Health. Turak. A slab of Furphy Refreshing Ale, unbelievable. And the Neighbours Cellar Shiraz with your photo on it. That's a good prize pack.
Beautiful. Thanks for that.
There we go.
Josh. Good. Number one in the studio. I think it's going to be hard to upgrade from here.
I'm a bit worried about my sort of... put a jacket on him and he's the host. So I might be a top. Go well, my man. Great to have you, Joshy. As we let you go, we've already reported that the Icon Iconic Moment will be back, and so too will the Quartermain Cup, where Dylan and I get a bit competitive and nitty-gritty and have a challenge every week. You enjoyed that, didn't you?
I did. It wasn't very competitive. I won that by landslide.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
I won a few.
You were meant to do a TikTok as well.
We'll get
I think it's
that.
Actually good that you didn't. But...
Let's have a look back at the Quartermain Cup from last season.
Welcome to the Quartermain Cup. This week, it's air hockey, quoit, table tennis, basketball, archery. As ever, Nick talking a really big game and producing very little. Nick, Buckets Butler versus dribbling Dylan Buckley.
Yeah! Oh.
Oh. The Saints.
Yeah!
This would have to be the worst standard of sport ever televised too, just quietly.
Yeah! Yeah! I reckon I was good.
That was bad.
Yeah, yeah, it's back. So, Neds are on board.
Oh, Neds, yeah, we love Neds.
They're all around the footy with the market. So the Neds boys are very creative and they liked our competitive juices. So we, and you don't know about this, I'll go through your manager, but we are sitting down with the Neds creative team next week about the new Quartermain Cup.
Yep.
I think maybe being an Olympic year, we could get a bit Olympic. I was a high jump champion, a 198,
I don't think
so
it
sort of the Frosby flop and get going. You would, I don't think you'd be able to jump onto the mat, would you? Got any ideas for the Neds guys?
I don't know, yeah, I'll have a think.
Not sprinting, I can't run.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Cricket?
No.
Anyway, so we will be challenging and we'll get the boys involved.
We will.
So when, you know, it's no risk for them to play, they can play, you know?
Yep.
That's great.
Yep.
Hey, social media. So
we love socials.
We are a social show and it's your thing. So
at 10sport.au, on all your good podcasting platforms, not podcasting actually, just social channels, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Check us out, 10sport.au. And send in some DMs because I'd like some messages. These messages we're getting at the moment, they're a bit tainted. I never see them.
No, they come in. They come in and with Furphy on board, we can flick you a few beanies and stubby holders and cartons. So get creative and if you want Dill to do something or you really like my hosting, let us know and give us some ideas and we'll reward you with some Furphy greatness. Now, we do have one early. Okay, so let's read it. It's from Contingency. Hi, guys. Great to read that Teams on 10 will be back for another year. I think you started off a bit rocky, but towards the end of last season, you really found your groove. I'm very excited about the Amazon doco called Making Their Mark and was happy to see Dylan hosting the online launch on Facebook. Yes, I watched that too. Now, I noticed Dylan was asking lots of hard-hitting questions. Is he hoping to become an award-winning journalist just like you, Nick? That is a very good question from Contingency. So let's have a look at your work in the Amazon Facebook launch.
Now, Dill, I'll let you kick things off.
Sure. First up, we have the president of the Richmond Football Club, Peggy O'Neill. Peggy, what's 2021 looking like from a board's perspective, I suppose? You look at the competition last year, it really didn't go to plan, but I suppose, has there been many contingency plans put in place for 2021?
So, look, I think you showed a bit of potential. You were really giving it to Peggy.
Yeah, hard-hitting.
Contingency. You're using big words. Contingency. You've got to open your mouth.
Yeah, I was speaking a bit quick, I think.
Oh, I do that. Yeah. That's okay. But I think, did you
enjoy it? I'm learning from the best.
You were like very Tom Brown-y, I reckon.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Yeah, you were. Yeah, you said, it's my time. Nat, you can wait, Nat. Because Nat is a star, and you said, give me Peggy because Peggy is the big cheese. She's probably the most powerful president.
It was a very good experience, and Peggy was actually quite daunting. I've sat down with a lot of high-profile people on the podcast, but chatting to a president, a CEO, it's scary.
Okay, well, I know that Chompers, like TJ, and was very impressed by your journalism. So you might get a call from Channel 9, but you are not to go.
Hopefully.
You are contracted now.
And we haven't signed anything.
You're all
yet.
You're not going.
Yeah, no, haven't signed anything.
I don't care. You can do your journalism here. Righto, hey, we're getting the wind-up, so we better get on to the tips, and we're very excited.
Oh, yeah.
Let's start a Richmond Carlton. Dylan Buckley's been out there. You had a few kicks one night, surely. You had 11 one night in one of those games.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Richmond Carlton, 50,000 at the G. How does it go down?
I've got to say Blues.
What?
I've got to. It's just boring if I say Richmond. It's the easy thing to say. I'm going to start the year off backing the underdogs. I think the Blues can finally, since 2012, I reckon they can win this one.
Who gets them over the line? Cripper?
Cripper. Cripper win the Brownlow this year.
I like it. Very Nedsy. See, the Neds market doesn't quite agree with you, but that's okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
There might be value. Collingwood and the Bulldogs. I'm looking forward to this as a bit of a media man.
Does Adam Treloar play this?
He's playing.
He's playing.
Yeah, he's
okay.
In and fired
Fantastic.
Up and wants to sort of EJ Witten shove it right up him.
Yeah. Okay.
Great game. No one cares about my tips. I think Collingwood are great with their backs to the wall and a big chance.
Yeah. Well, I actually think the Dogs will win this. Their midfield is going to be incredible. It's the problem's getting them all through there. But watch this space. Stephen Martin this year putting it down the boys' throats in the midfield. There's going to be so many players. So their midfield's going to be great. They've never had a ruckman, by the way.
No,
really.
Big man.
Yeah.
34 or something, but still moves well.
Yeah.
I like it. Okay, Melbourne Frio. I'll tell you what, the Ds need an early win or two or the heat comes.
Yep.
How does that play out?
Yeah, I think Frio are going to win this.
Okay, any reason why, quickly?
Oh, I just think they're young players. I love Caleb Sarong. Hayden Young coming in, a lot of people might not know about him. I reckon he'll nearly win the Rising Star this year too.
Okay, okay. Crows v Geelong. Jeremy Cameron, not Jezza Clayton. Jezza Clayton was on the Port Adelaide team. Sorry, I said that earlier. Jezza's first hit out in the five. How does that go down?
I think they win this quite easily.
Yeah. Essendon, Hawthorn, Clarko factor. You were strong on Essendon on the radio.
I did. I think the Dons probably need a lift this year. Like, they've probably got away with a little bit of poor form. I think Hawks will win this as well, even though people are sort of riding off the Hawks, I feel, but you can never ride off Clarkson.
No, you're becoming a journo. You're putting the heat on teams.
No, I'm not.
I like it. Brisbane, Sydney.
Brisbane. Joe Danaher factor, I think, is going to be huge for the Lions.
How many does he kick?
I'm going to say 60 plus.
Yes. Your big statements. Ruse, Port, Port ominous, they reckon. Super fit.
Yeah, I have heard this. Port will win this one, especially early. As we've heard with their training programs, they go super hard, so they've just got to sustain it.
And your old Giants up against Joshy Battle and St Kilda.
Giants, St Kilda. Giants need a bounce back this year. They were very disappointed with their efforts. But in saying that, even though they've got eight out, the Saints, I think the Saints are prime for a top 8-4 finish. So I'm going with the Saints.
Well, like it. Wouldn't Melbourne just be buzzing if they start to get it rolling? And the final game, the Eagles up against the improving Gold Coast Suns. Your old lover boy.
Yes, this is a tough one. I love the West Coast Eagles. They're one of my favourite teams, but I also love the Gold Coast Suns. Matt Rao back. It's.
Will you DM him?
I will. I'm a little good lucky.
I've tried.
Yeah, no, nothing. That's fair. So I'm going to go with the Suns.
Good man. Hey, that was a Teams on 10 round one. We probably could have used with a little intra club or something. We're a bit rough, but stick with us. Thank you to Furphy for being on board. There'll be more next week.